A new startup idea, yet to become a formal company, focuses on delivering off-world construction services. The team criticizes NASA's approach to construction, but before we get into that, let's consider the concept of purchasing such services. This emerging business model, known as Construction as a Service, or CAS, outsources complex construction expertise to specialized providers. It enables clients, such as space agencies, to concentrate on their missions without managing the complexities of equipment adaption or teleoperation. Applied to lunar construction, CAS would include ongoing maintenance and adaptive services for habitats. Think of CAS as a service-based approach to off-world development. Base building on the moon demands various construction activities. For example, teams must clear, level, compact, and possibly sinter the ground at a base before placing a habitat there. This essential preparation applies not only to habitats, but also to power stations, shelters, landing pads, rail tracks, warehouses, or processing and mining sites. Now, let's examine LunarCore Construction Services and their offering. This Canadian startup, still in its formative stages, seeks to crowdfund capital for incorporating a company and kickstarting initial research. With the first $5,000, they will incorporate as a Canadian corporation, making it easier to compete for government grants. If the campaign raises $100,000, the startup can launch research and development on its lunar shotcrete, a robust construction material blending lunar regolith with a binder. Development of a remote lunar excavator would also begin. Reaching the $200,000 funding threshold would provide a 2 to 4 month runway to pursue grants ranging from $250,000 to $850,000. You can check out their crowdfunding page to see all the funding levels and read more details about the company. I've included a link in the video description. Their mission statement is deliver safe, cost-efficient, and rapidly deployable subsurface habitats and subsurface industrial facilities on the Moon and Mars, using proven construction technologies, applying conventional building methods in a novel manner to shape humanity's off-world future. Whatever your thoughts on their funding success, it's worth looking at LunarCore's sharp critique of existing off-world construction strategies and its proposed solution, constructing lunar habitats. LunarCore envisions lunar habitats carved beneath the moon's surface, shielded from radiation and meteorites. The company plans to draw on practical construction expertise, employing proven methods similar to those used on Earth. After all, humanity has built infrastructure on Earth for thousands of years, developing highly reliable and effective techniques along the way. China is pushing to be the first country to go back to the moon after the US left in the 1970s. What NASA and the Artemis partners need is to be able to build bases fast and without incurring astronomical costs. The question is, how can they achieve this? First, let's look at the problems with NASA's current construction plans as outlined by LunarCore. NASA prioritizes experimentation over practical solutions. Cosmic radiation bombards the surface with around 500 millisieverts per year, 200 times Earth's background level. This figure excludes solar flares, which unleash far higher radiation fluxes that could prove lethal to unprotected astronauts. Indeed, even moderately shielded habitats might fail to prevent acute radiation poisoning or death during intense events. Underground shelters offer essential protection against these deadly storms. Extreme temperature swings add to the difficulties, plummeting to minus 170 degrees Celsius during the lunar night and soaring to 120 degrees Celsius in the day. Without an atmosphere, all equipment and structures must remain airtight to maintain viability. Low gravity complicates traction, hindering vehicles from ascending steep slopes or digging effectively without risking toppling over. Pervasive lunar dust, sharp and electrostatically charged, invades every crevice, including cooling vents crucial for preventing equipment overheating. Finally, the moon's average distance of 400,000 kilometers from Earth introduces communication delays on the near side and renders direct contact with the far side impossible without lunar data relay satellites. As you can see, there are lots of problems that need to be overcome to build infrastructure on the moon. The cost of transporting construction equipment and materials to the moon remains extremely expensive. 1 ton of equipment costs $1 billion to the lunar surface. With new lunar landers, particularly SpaceX's Starship, the cost could drop to $100 million per ton. Even at this lower price point, lunar construction is very costly. To make projects viable, lunar resources must be used as much as possible, minimizing resupply missions from Earth. LunarCore's first criticism of planned lunar construction methods is the use of 3D printing. I've covered companies like Icon Technologies on this channel previously, which develops large-scale 3D printers for lunar applications. LunarCore considers 3D printers for off-world construction to be cumbersome, slow, and unproven. In terms of speed, these printers can excavate at 0.3 to 0.6 cubic meters per hour. They require human assistance and oversight and are not robust enough in vacuum environments like the moon. LunarCore states that these 3D printing machines struggle with airtight seals, an absolute critical requirement for lunar habitats. Such flaws undermine the practicality of 3D printing on the moon or other off-world sites, at least without extensive further development that could span years or decades. Rover-based technologies offer little improvement. These lightweight systems, typically under half a ton, are suited only for small-scale tasks such as exploration and surveying. True construction requires large, powerful, heavy-duty equipment weighing many tons, driven by basic physics. In the moon's low gravity, a flimsy lightweight rover attempting to dig into regolith would likely flip over. Substantial mass is essential as a counterbalance, a principle that holds on Earth but becomes far more critical in low gravity settings like the moon. Space agencies like NASA and ESA choose what they are most familiar with. NASA has been operating rovers on Mars for many decades now and are comfortable with this technology, which their development pipeline continues to prioritize. From JPL and universities, each mission looks similar, an autonomous, lightweight robot. Is it any wonder NASA's plans for construction involve the use of autonomous, lightweight robots or rovers? According to LunarCore, rover-based construction continues not due to its proven efficacy, but because it aligns with NASA's historical practices and the payload constraints of traditional launch vehicles. If you examine terrestrial excavation and construction methods refined over thousands of years, none resemble NASA's current strategies. How many Earth-based construction projects use automation? Few, if any. That's because these systems don't accelerate construction, quite the reverse. If autonomous construction was useful, it would already be widely deployed around the world for construction. NASA's emphasis on 3D printers for lunar construction favors experimentation over reliability. Proven, practical Earth-based methods exist and can adapt to the lunar environment. Sandvik Mining offers the TH550B, a battery-powered underground mining truck with a 50-ton capacity that supports remote operation. This vehicle features a high-performance electric driveline, ideal for deep mining environments. Operators can control it from a remote station, using features such as predictive wall avoidance and assisted steering. With zero exhaust emissions and reduced heat output, it holds potential for adaption to lunar conditions. Batteries swap out quickly to minimize downtime, and the truck has seen extensive use in underground hard rock applications. LunarCore intends to deploy remotely operated excavation equipment, operated by experienced construction professionals, to guarantee speed and safety. Let's now explore LunarCore's solution in greater detail. LunarCore's solution, practical construction as a general contractor. LunarCore aims to serve as a general contractor and construction manager for off-world projects, managing projects using proven Earth technologies adapted for the specific environment for the construction project. The company's custom-designed teleoperated excavator optimized for lunar conditions, weighs 3 tons. Skilled operators would control it remotely from either a mission control center on Earth or lunar orbit. Delays from Earth would last 1 to 2 seconds, while those from the orbiting gateway station would be nearly instantaneous. Teleoperating the excavator offers greater safety than placing an astronaut on board a vehicle and proves simpler than developing an autonomous system. The LunarCore excavator digs to a depth of 5 to 10 meters and can excavate 2 to 4 cubic meters an hour. It can create a 100 cubic meter enclosure in 4 to 8 days, outpacing 3D printers or rover-based methods. LunarCore's shotcrete, when applied to floors or walls, provides 25 megapascals of strength. This enables regolith to serve as load-bearing structures in subsurface habitats. The company plans to incorporate a simple airlock, a prefabricated, inflatable or rigid airtight entry hatch sourced from industrial partners, to seal the subsurface habitat area. LunarCore considers their 100 cubic meter sealed subsurface habitat to be a beachhead. Once completed with functional air circulation and a large aperture airlock in place, this habitat allows the use of more traditional terrestrial-style excavation equipment to expand its volume. Such an approach eliminates the need to operate in a vacuum or endure the moon's extreme surface temperature fluctuations. LunarCore uses locally sourced construction materials as much as possible, with 95% of the material being lunar soil. This strategy restricts the initial launch mass to just the construction equipment and the binder required for the shotcrete. As a result, production costs plummet. Once the construction equipment is deployed to the moon, additional projects have much lower costs, limited to binder replenishment and equipment spares or replacements. Their first planned project would be lunar landing pad construction, enabling the company to validate its concepts directly on the moon's surface. Space agencies are likely to fund landing pads as one of the earliest priorities, as the risk of landing or launching from unprepared ground is risky and would spray nearby settlements with ejecta and dust. Later projects could be reactor complex or industrial contracts. LunarCore's subsurface construction expertise aligns perfectly with exploiting lunar lava tubes. These natural formations exist across various lunar regions and offer expansive underground spaces ripe for conversion into settler habitats. Tasks such as leveling the ground, installing entrance ramps, shoring up ceilings, and widening tunnels all suit the company's equipment. Moreover, this gear would excel in mining operations, a key objective of the Artemis program, which emphasizes in-situ resource utilization to make operating on the moon more sustainable. Advantages to LunarCore's approach. A teleoperated excavator would outperform an unproven and untested 3D printing or rover system. LunarCore estimates that a habitat could be constructed for $10 to $20 million as compared to $70 to $80 million for 3D printed structures. Most of that cost would be launch costs. Habitats would be deployed more rapidly than with alternative solutions. Early missions between 2028 and 2030 could produce habitats with a volume of 50 to 100 cubic meters. LunarCore will use real-world construction expertise, unlike competitors that focus on experimental tech. They will apply established practices such as excavation and stabilization techniques rated at TRL level 9, the highest technology readiness level. By positioning itself as a dedicated construction company, LunarCore anticipates generating revenue from the various lunar activities demanding site preparation and infrastructure. This model extends seamlessly to Mars and beyond. In contrast to competitors, LunarCore has comparatively low capital expenditures. Their practical approach to off-world construction minimizes the research and development costs of competitors with novel and untried methods. Why now? The NASA Artemis program has allocated billions of dollars to lunar-based construction. The Canadian Space Agency, CSA, plans on spending $1.9 billion on lunar investment. SpaceX invests billions in its Mars ambitions, while the European Space Agency pursues permanent lunar habitation in the 2030s and eyes Martian settlements later that decade. All these missions require skilled builders for essential infrastructure, including landing pads, unpressurized shelters, habitats, shoring up lava tubes, ground preparation for nuclear reactors, mining sites, rail network embankments, and more. With funding, LunarCore stands ready to test its excavation approach using lunar simulants by 2026. The company would then bid for grants from NASA, the CSA, ESA, and JAXA. Challenges. By far the biggest challenge for LunarCore is funding. Raising at least $5,000 would enable the company to incorporate and pursue grants from governments and space agencies. Another challenge is changing NASA's mindset, away from testing new technology and using practical, proven, but unsexy approaches, such as remotely operated equipment. Adapting Earth construction equipment for operation in a vacuum that can handle extreme temperatures remains uncertain. Teleoperated vehicles with electric power systems represent the most promising Earth-based candidates for lunar modification. Upcoming events. With funding, testing of the excavation approach could begin in 2026. What do you think of the idea of construction as a service for the moon? Do you agree with LunarCore's criticisms of NASA's strategy, which prioritizes experimentation with novel methods over proven Earth-based construction techniques? Leave your thoughts and opinions in the comments section below. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this space video, consider buying me a coffee to help fund more episodes like this. The link is in the description. Space News Live is on Saturday evening or Sunday morning, depending where you watch from. The live stream is a great way for you to share your thoughts and opinions on the videos I posted this week or on any space topic in general. I highlight the most thought-provoking comments on videos I've received, along with previews of upcoming content. If you've got the time, please tune in and say hi. Be sure to like and subscribe so you'll see our upcoming videos. We make videos every week covering the space industry with an emphasis on the smaller space startups that aren't covered so well on other channels. See you soon.